laparoscopic repair of vesicovaginal fistula. Gynecological causes for vesicovaginal fistula are common nowadays. Vesicovaginal fistula due to gynecological causes, unlike those due to obstetric causes, can be managed early. 8 women developed vesicovaginal fistula following hysterectomy. Cystoscopy was done initially to examine the fistula. Cystoscopy revealed a less than 1 cm supratrigonal fistula. Ureteric stents were placed on either side. Laparoscopy was done using 5 ports. The patient was put in the head low position. Initial dissection was done between the bladder and the adjoining bowel. There were only flimsy adhesions which could be easily separated. Inflammatory tissue was noted at the site of the fistula. Now the bladder was filled and bivalving was started. We used the O'Connor's technique, where the bladder was bivalved and it was opened up to the level of the fistula. As the bladder was continuing to close, a stay stitch was taken on either side of the bladder wall and it was fixed to the abdominal wall. The division of the bladder was continued. An infant feeding tube was placed through the fistula and sharp dissection could be easily done to encircle the entire fistula, including the wall of the vagina. As the fistula was excised, we could see the Foley balloon placed in the vagina, which was placed initially to prevent any leakage of air through the vagina during the procedure of laparoscopy. Once the fistula was excised, it was removed in toto. At this stage, it was reasonably easy to develop a good plane between the vagina and the bladder. The vaginal wall was held with a toothed forceps and dissection was carried out to make a good plane between the vagina and the bladder. Then the vaginal vault was closed with barbed stitches. Barbed stitches are very useful in the sense, once it is tightened, it doesn't become loose. Vascular omentum was brought down into the pelvis and placed between the vagina and the bladder and fixed with Vicryl's sutures. Unhealthy looking edges in the bladder wall were trimmed. Healthy bladder wall was brought in and sutured to the fistula wall using barbed stitches. It was easy to maintain the tension in the wall as barbed stitches do not become loose once it is let. Further suturing of the bladder is being continued. Bladder wall closure was completed using the same stitches and the sutures were checked by filling the bladder and making sure there is no leakage. A drain was placed in the pelvis. The surgery took between 150 to 180 minutes. Patients were in the hospital for 5 days. None of the 8 patients had any recurrence of the fistula. Early laparoscopic repair of gynecological vesicovaginal fistula is feasible and reduces the distress in the patients. Thank you.